How do, and welcome to A Bit More Yorkshire Brass. It's David Hoyle with you once again for another week of brass and banter. What a piece of music we started with today. That was the Venezuelan Brass Ensemble playing Aaron Copland's Fanfare for the Common Man. Bob in Scarborough got in touch to say, can we have a 70s classic? Well, Bob, absolutely, not a problem, and it was a 70s chart classic for Emerson, Lake and Palmer. But what you may not know is that the piece was actually written in the 1940s, way back in 1942. It's a cracking piece and a great way to start another couple of hours of brass and banter. Thanks for all your requests, your dedications and emails this week. Let's get on with the first march. David in Poynton with this one. A few local bands have won a few pounds with this on brass band contesting fields and platforms. William Rimmer's Honest Toil is the march, and the Marple Band are playing here. Thank you. The Marple Band playing Honest Toil by William Rimmer. That was for David in Poynton, who is very much looking forward to the March season. Yeah, it'll be up on us in a few weeks' time, won't it, and run through the summer. The March contests, the March and Hymn contests. I love playing outdoors and seeing so many people gathering to watch and to listen to the bands. Overture time now. Hello to Kevin in Leeds and happy birthday for this coming week. Kevin says, I've got a big zero birthday. I'm not going to tell you which one it is, Oily, but the first number's a bit lucky. How dare you? You've picked a cracker, absolute cracker of an overture by Beethoven, Kevin. Thanks for doing this. And the recording I have for you this week is by the Foden's Band. Let's have a listen to this week's overture, which Kevin has chosen, Egmont.
Thank you.
week's overture, Egmont by Beethoven, was played by the Foden's Band, written by Beethoven in between October 1809 and June 1810, and it had its premiere later that year. It's just such a regal piece of music, particularly the ending with the sort of semi-fanfare bit. I just think it's a brilliant overture. Thanks to Kevin in Leeds. Happy big birthday, my friend. And thanks, as always, for listening. Our first solo spot of the week, well, it's actually a duet this week. Tim the Tuba has been in touch to say, are there any duets for tubas? Me and my buddy are looking for something to play. There are a few, not loads, to be honest, but this one is a really good one. It's a Simon Kirwin arrangement, and it features the Rothwell Temperance Band with Simon Moffat and Andy Goldfinch as the tuba soloist. Let's have a listen to T for Tubas. A great arrangement by Simon Kerwin, Tea for Tubers, based, of course, on the lovely tune Tea for Two. Simon Moffat and Andy Goldfinch, the tuba soloists, with the Rothwell Temperance Band, were playing that for Tim the tuba, who was looking for suggestions for a tuba duet. Well, I think that would do you really, really nicely, Tim, and thanks for getting in touch on the email, yorkshirebrass@gmail.com. That's the email address to use if you want to get in touch with any requests, dedications, or just any general messages. It's always great to hear from you. Nick in Rochdale is up next. We're having a go at this piece in our band. Well, funnily enough, Nick, so are we. Would you please play Daryl Barry's Dance to the Daddy on your show anytime coming up soon? Well, today's the day I'm going to do that. I'm actually playing on this recording as well with the Linley Band. Here we go. Dance to the Daddy. Thank you. The Lindley Band playing Daryl Barry's arrangement, Dance to the Daddy. The music there based on the Northeast folk song, When the Boat Comes In. It was also used as a BBC TV series soundtrack of the same name, When the Boat Comes In. James Bolam was in that series, I seem to remember. Lovely piece of music, thanks to Nick in Rochdale. Off to West Witten, lovely part of the country, and our Louise has been in touch. Could I please hear the flugel solo arranged by Alan Ferney? What a Wonderful World, the Louis Armstrong music. Yes, absolutely. This works so, so well for brass band Louise. She says, I'm going to have a go at this and see if I can actually manage to play it. Well, I think you will be able to do, Flower, and I wish you all the best with it. Here's Joanne Childs with the Corey Band.
Thank you.
The lovely sound of Joanne Childs on the flugelhorn with the Corey Band. That was Alan Fernie's arrangement of What a Wonderful World. Yes, indeed. Thanks to Louise in West Witten for that one. Now, this week's specialist subject, What a Wonderful World. Well, I'm going to say What a Wonderful Country, America, because we're going to look at some strange laws which have been passed over the years in different states of America. And some of them are just so funny they are stupid. And some of them are just unbelievable. You think, really? Why? Let's start in Alabama. I'm going to sort of go through these alphabetically, and we won't get them all done this week, I will warn you. In Anniston, Alabama, you may not wear blue jeans down Noble Street. Doesn't say why. You just can't wear blue jeans if you're going down Noble Street. Bear wrestling matches are prohibited totally in Alabama. Well, thank goodness for that. Sorry to spoil your Sundays, but you can't play dominoes in Alabama on a Sunday. I presume that's something to do with gambling. It's illegal for a driver to be blindfolded whilst operating a vehicle. Well, thank goodness for that. And it's also illegal to wear a fake moustache that causes any laughter in church. Why would anybody want to wear a fake moustache to go to church? It's a bit like the copper in Alolo. Good morning, with that moustache. It is legal to drive the wrong way down a one-way street, providing that you have a lantern attached to the front of your vehicle. In Montgomery, Alabama, it is considered an offence to open an umbrella on the street for fear of it spooking horses. What a strange law. If you own an alligator, it is illegal to chain it to a fire hydrant. Why would anybody want to walk an alligator and then chain it to a fire hydrant? You cannot drive barefooted. I agree with that. That's not a silly law. That's common sense. And finally, in Alabama, you may not have an ice cream cone in your back pocket at any time. Let's move on now to Alaska. Even though it is legal to hunt a bear in Alaska, it's illegal to wake a bear up and take a picture for photo opportunities. It's also illegal in Alaska to whisper in someone's ear while they are moose hunting. These are crazy, aren't they? It's considered an offence to push a live moose out of a moving aeroplane. Really? Really? Kangaroos are not allowed in a barber shop at any time. I didn't know even know there were any kangaroos in Alaska. And moose may not be viewed from an airplane, or an aeroplane, as we call it. More of these in a little while. Judy in Wakefield is next up. Could you please play me something early by the Carpenters for my birthday, which is on the 9th of April. You have a lovely birthday, Judy, and you've sort of said anything of your choice. Well, I'm going to do a montage because I think this is a brilliant montage. We've played it a few times on the show. The James Shepherd Versatile Brass Group are playing here, and it is just most things Carpenters. It's called Carpenteria. Thank you. Classic Carpenters. Carpenteria, the name of that piece of music. James Shepherd Versatile Brass were playing to wish Judy in Wakefield a very happy birthday. Classic stuff, mainly from the 1970s there. We're going to the year 2000 next for Steve in Bingley and a film theme which our good friend Sandy Smith arranged for brass band. Steve says, I think this is absolutely brilliant. It works so well. And you get a chance to play a kazoo as well as part of proceedings. This is by John Powell and Harry Gregson Williams, and the Yorkshire Imperial Band play the theme from the film Chicken Run. Thank you. The theme from the film Chicken Run, the year 2000, when the film came out. John Powell and Harry Gregson-Williams, responsible for the original composition. Sandy Smith, our very own Sandy Smith, with the brass band arrangement, which was played there by the Yorkshire Imperial Band for Steve in Bingley. Next up, it's the thoughtful piece of the week, that time when we play a lovely slow piece of music, which just resonates with the audience. Beautiful, beautiful choices, and today is no difference. I've played this one very recently indeed. Mary in Huddersfield, thank you very much for choosing this one. It's an arrangement by Philip Harper, and Philip's conducting the Polysteel Band on this recording of The Water of Tyne. That's an absolutely smashing piece of music, isn't it? Perfect for our reflective spot. The Water of Tyne, arranged by Philip Harper and played there by the Polysteel Band for Mary in Huddersfield. Now then, Mick in Halifax, another one with a big birthday and a big 7-0. You're in Halifax, as I say, and your family have been in touch. Lee, Joanne, Abby, Jack and Flipper. Flipper the goldfish. I think it's the first time ever I've had a request from a goldfish on my show. Your family say you're a big Elton John fan and could we please play something on this show on the 6th of April to celebrate your birthday. Well, this is another montage. There's quite a number of Elton John stuff being arranged for brass band, but this one, well, it's just a great way to end the first half and to wish Mick in Halifax a happy 70th birthday. Daryl Barry made the arrangement for brass band. Once again, another Daryl Barry arrangement, and the Yorkshire Building Society Band are playing here. This is the essential Elton John. We'll be right back. The Yorkshire Building Society Band playing Daryl Barry's arrangement, The Essential, Elton John. We're wishing Mick in Halifax a very happy 70th birthday, and a lovely sounding family made that request. Lee, Joanne, Abby, Jack and Flipper, the goldfish. Now, we began this week's programme with a classic, Fanfare for the Common Man, which was released into the UK charts in the 1970s, 1977 in fact, even though it was written in the 40s. We're going to begin the second part of the programme with another classic from the 1970s, this time from 1978. Sid in Kilmarnock has been in touch. Can I please hear the brass band version of The Eve of the War by Jeff Wayne? Yes, indeed. This is an arrangement by Christian Jenkins and played by the Black Dyke Band. The music of Jeff Wayne, The Eve of the War from War of the Worlds, an arrangement there by Christian Jenkins, played by the Black Dyke Band, thanks to Sid in Kilmarnock for getting in touch with that one. Let's have a few more of these strange and quite frankly silly laws sometimes in America. We're moving on now to Arizona. Now then, how about this one? It is illegal for a donkey to have a bath. I should think so. In Glendale, cars may not be driven in reverse. That's quite interesting. How do you get into a parking space if you can't drive a car in reverse? Can't always go in forwards, can you? The hunting of camels is prohibited. I'm glad to hear that. It is also illegal in Arizona for men and women over the age of 18 to have less than one missing tooth visible when smiling. Well, unbelievable that, really. It's also unlawful to refuse a person a glass of water if they ask for one. I should think so as well. In Mojave County, a decree there declares that anyone caught stealing soap must wash with it until it's all used up. That'll stop them from stealing. Let's go on to Arkansas. A law in Arkansas provides that school teachers who bob their hair will not get a pay rise. Oh dear. Alligators may not be kept in bathtubs. That's a very good idea. I can't stand alligators. Or crocodiles. They give me the creeps. Arkansas must not be pronounced as Arkansas, and anyone who pronounces it as Arkansas is liable to an on-the-spot fine. In Arkansas, it is illegal to buy or sell blue light bulbs. Goodness me. California, let's do this one. Baldwin Park in California. Nobody is allowed to ride a bicycle in a swimming pool. Well, who the devil would want to do that anyway? In Blythe, you are not permitted to wear cowboy boots unless you already own at least two cows. Ridiculous. In Burlingham, it is illegal to spit except on baseball diamonds. Caramel ice cream may not be eaten while standing on the sidewalk or the pavement. But that was repealed when Clint Eastwood was the mayor, by the way. And women may not wear high heels while in the city limits. Disgraceful. If they want to wear them, let them wear them. It is illegal in California to try to drive more than 2,000 sheep down Hollywood Boulevard at any one time. Can't imagine anybody trying to do that because it's always so busy down there. Anyway, it's also against state regulations to let your phone ring for more than 9 times in an office. Hey, they should bring that in England. We might actually get to speak to someone. You cannot, well, it is illegal actually, to go into a court and to cry on the witness stand. I think that's a bit cruel, really. And it's illegal in Lodi to own or sell silly string. What happened to silly string? It used to be everywhere here, and it was awful stuff because you couldn't get it off. It's illegal to set a mousetrap without a hunting license in California. Well, just buy a hunting license because mice are a nuisance. And women, I'm sorry again, this is California, you may not drive your car in a house coat. I don't see what difference it makes, really, unless the coat gets in the way of your feet, and then that's a different thing altogether. Now then, next up, we've got the second March of the week, and this is to wish Pauline a happy birthday. Pauline will be celebrating with Julie and Andrew, her family, at the Harrogate Showground site. Yes, you'll be going for your jollies. You'll be going for a little bit of a break, the caravan park up there in Harrogate. So have a good few days, and Andrew and Julie have asked me to pick one of the road matches which we used to play in the junior band. Well, I'm going for the old favourite by William Rimmer. This is a recording by the Dinnington Colliery Band. Happy birthday, Pauline. Here we go with Slade Burn. Thank you. the Dinnington Colliery Band playing the old favourite, William Rimmer's Sleigh Burn. We wish Pauline a very happy birthday. Thanks to Julie and Andrew for the request. Catch up with you soon, Pauline, at another concert in Slowit. Our next solo of the week has been chosen by Caroline and Peter in Halifax. It's a lovely, slow piece of music written by Joy Webb and the brass band arrangement by Ivor Bazanko. Sophie Howes is the soloist on this lovely recording with the Verwood Concert Brass Group. Let's have a listen to Share My Yoke. another lovely piece of music. Share My Yoke, Ivor Bazanko's arrangement of the music of Joy Webb. Sophie House was a soloist with Verwood Concert Brass. That was played for Caroline and Peter in Halifax. Hello there, says Phil in Dublin, and I'm reading from his email, by the way, yorkshirebrass@gmail.com, the very email address that Phil used. I'd like to play a piece of music which is dedicated to myself, and I firmly believe it was written all about me, because I play the flute, give over. No, seriously, he sent me a video, and he does play the flute. Gordon Langford made this arrangement for brass band, played here by the Black Dyke Mills Band. Do you live in a place called Ballymuck? Have you heard of Phil the Fluter from the town of Ballymuck? Let's have a listen to Phil the Fluter's Ball. Gordon Langford's arrangement of Phil the Fluter's Ball, played by the Black Dyke Band, playing for Phil in Dublin, who happens to play the flute. How dare you? How dare you choose such a lovely piece of music, Phil? Thank you very much indeed for that one. Now, a cartoon theme coming up next for Kerry in Edinburgh. I believe there is a brass band version of the theme tune to Scooby-Doo, Where Are You?, says Kerry. There certainly is, and a Scottish band playing for you here. The Whitburn Band, Andrew Duncan conducting the band, and it's his arrangement. Here we go, Scooby-Doo, Where Are You? Raggy?
Thank you.
Whitburn Band playing Andrew Duncan's arrangement of the theme music to Scooby-Doo, Where Are You? Oh, fond memories of my childhood indeed. Carrie in Edinburgh with the request. Thanks, Carrie, for that one. We're going up next to Cone, or down to Cone, actually, from Edinburgh. Cone in Lancashire. Our Sue's been in touch and found an old recording by the Hammond Sourceworks Band, which she would very much like to share with the listeners of the programme. It's a euphonium duet this time. We had a tuba duet in the first part of the show. This features Brian Crooks and Morgan Griffiths with the Hammond Sourceworks Band, and it's the music of John Denver. Perhaps Love. That's lovely, isn't it? A euphonium duet featuring Brian Crooks and Morgan Griffiths with the Hammond Sourceworks Band. The music of John Denver, Perhaps Love, was requested by Sue in Cone. Let's go back to the list again, the final few for this week. Connecticut, as most people call it. A pickle is not actually a pickle unless it bounces. Who gives a pickle? I don't like pickles anyway. Balloons with advertising on them are illegal in Hartford. In Bloomfield, it's against the law to eat in your car. In Devon, not Devon, UK, but Devon, Connecticut, it is unlawful to walk backwards after sunset. Well, you might bump into someone. Only Christmas lights are allowed for display in Guildford. Any time, other time of the year, not allowed. And in Hartford, you aren't allowed to cross a street while walking on your hands. Well, who would try that anyway? And finally, in Connecticut, you are not allowed to educate a dog. That's a bit silly, because dogs are clever animals, and the more you educate them, the better they behave. In Delaware, it is prohibited to race any kind of horse on Good Friday and Easter Sunday, and so it should be. I agree with that. And also in Delaware, it's illegal to get married on a day. I dare you. I dare you to get married. Yeah, why, yeah, I see that. Finally, in District of Columbia. In Washington, it's illegal to post a notice in public which calls another person a coward for refusing to accept a challenge to a duel. Oh dear. It's also unlawful for small boys to throw stones at any time in the District of Columbia. And how about this for a final one? The US government says that it's a crime to give false weather reports. Can they come over to Yorkshire, please? Because I am absolutely sick of one of our local news agencies, if you can call them that, in Yorkshire, posting ridiculous things about when it's going to snow. And it never does, or it rarely does. And then we're going to have a bad weather phenomenon and this, that and the other. Let's just bring it in that only official weather outlets can do weather forecast. Thank you so much. Next up, we are going to Paul in Falkirk, another one of our Scottish listeners, and another piece of music played by the Whitburn Band. Again, Andrew Duncan is conducting the band, and this time the arrangement is by Steve Sykes. Paul says, I love the music of Queen, and I think this is brilliant for brass band. Could I please hear Queen Rules? You certainly can. Here we go. Thank you. Sykes' arrangement of Queen Rules, yes, a montage of music by Queen, played for Paul in Falkirk there by the Whitburn Band. Thanks, Paul, for your request. Pete in Huddersfield has chosen our test piece this week on the Yorkshire Brass Facebook group. If you're not a member, pop onto Facebook, type in Yorkshire Brass. It's a closed user group and we talk about anything brass banding. It's a jolly group and there are lots of problems get solved on there in relation to music as well. This was a National Spinal Test piece not long ago, music by Joseph Horowitz, and the Sun Life Stanshaw Band are playing here. Ballet for Band is this week's test piece.
Thank you.
Sun Life Stanshaw Band playing this week's test piece. The music of Joseph Horowitz, Ballet for Band. Thanks to Pete in Huddersfield for choosing that one. Our hymn tune slot this week has been reserved by Seville Holt on email. Thanks, Seville, for getting in touch. And yes, absolutely, we have to play this particular piece of music because we're now in the month of April. We nearly forgot last year, so I'm doing it early this month, getting it in on the first possible programme I can, says he with a smile on his face. Eric Ball made this arrangement of the music of Hugh Robertson, and the Grimthorpe Colliery Band are playing for you, Seville, as requested, all in the April evening. I've played that piece of music since I was 7 years old, and I will never tire of playing it. Audiences love to hear it, all in the April evening. This week's hymn tune slot, chosen by Saville Holt, with the Grimthorpe Colliery Band playing the music of Hugh Roberton and that lovely arrangement for brass band by Eric Ball. And so we come to the end of another programme. Yes, another programme gone by. 206 now in our online series of A Bit More Yorkshire Brass. Thanks from me, David Hoyle, for all your requests and your dedications this week. Keep them coming in. We are working about 6 or 7 weeks in advance for compliance purposes now. yorkshirebrass@gmail.com is the email address for any requests and dedications. We're finishing today with a request for Dan. Dan is in Blackpool and he loves this classical piece of music, brass band style. If possible, could I have the Alan Fernie arrangement of this one played by the Black Dyke Band? You certainly can, Dan. Thanks for the request. Thanks, everybody. Back next week with another show, 207. Have a great week. Take it easy. And we're finishing off this week with the music of Verdi, which is indeed arranged by Alan Fernie. This is the Grand March from Aida. Thanks again. See you next week. Ta-ra!